Hello everyone, I'm Andrew Can, and if I can, you can too. Today I'm going to teach you how to live stream using a DSLR and the Elgato Cam Link 4K. Here's the gear I'll be using to stream to a DSLR, or in my case, a mirrorless Panasonic G7, the Elgato Cam Link 4K. Micro HDMI to HDMI cable, and a battery outlet adapter so your camera won't shut off mid-stream. An Amazon affiliate link will be in the description down below for all of the gear you'll need for this exact setup. It's important to note that the Elgato Cam Link 4K may not support your camera if your setup is different than mine. And you can check out their site, which will also be linked in the description down below, for what cameras they support. For example, the Cam Link 4K didn't work perfectly with my Canon EOS Rebel SL1, but how to set it up is similar with my Panasonic G7. I'll be using my EOS Rebel SL1 as a stand-in for this video, but we'll be filming and streaming from the G7. Out of the box, you get the Elgato Cam Link 4K and a USB 3.0 extension cable. All you need to do is plug in the HDMI cable to the Cam Link, and the correct HDMI port to your camera. In the case with the G7, it's a micro HDMI port. Then, insert your Elgato Cam Link into a USB 3.0 port. Next, we'll add the AC adapter. Head over to your camera's battery compartment and slide in the outlet adapter. Then on the right side, you should notice a small piece of plastic you can move to run the cord through. Then just attach the battery to the wall unit and plug it in. You'll want to attach your camera to a tripod. This could be one that rests on your desk, or one like mine where it's slightly above your monitors. Attach your camera and get the angle just right. You may need to change your camera's setting for the quality, look, and a clean HDMI out. Otherwise, you'll get the information displayed with your stream like this. We don't want this. For the Panasonic G7, I change the color profile to natural and keep the image at 4K 30 frames per second. Once done here, scroll down to the setup menu. It's the option with the lone wrench. Head to the third setup menu and select TV connection. Switch that to off and boom, you have a clean HDMI out. To stream, you will need to open your streaming software. For this video, I'll be using OBS Studio, but this works with a multitude of streaming services. So this is the standard live stream setup, and I'm using a Logitech C920 to get this look accomplished. Now, I'm going to be using the Elgato Cam Link 4K to switch to a DSLR, but I want to show you how you can set up that here in OBS, because it's very easy to do and a lot of fun. So let's go ahead and jump into OBS down here. So immediately, what we're going to see is going to be slightly different from what I have. You're going to immediately want to go to settings, and here's where you're going to want to check everything out. So first thing I want to do is make sure I'm in video. Now for me, I usually live stream out to 920 by 1080, as you can see it here. So you're gonna wanna make sure your common FPS value is 29.7 if you're using the Panasonic G7. If not, you wanna use whatever your camera has natively. Of course, you can change this to 24 frames per second. I usually keep it at 29.97, but the Panasonic G7 can go up to 60 frames per second. So if you're doing it for gaming, you can easily just jump up to 60 frames per second. But I'm just gonna be using it for simple live streaming purposes. Now, I already have everything set up, so what we're gonna do is we are going to create a new scene, and we're gonna call this Cam Link scene, just so we know that this is using the Cam Link 4K, and that it is not using the same thing. Now, what you'll notice is in the background, I'm still recording the audio using this audio track, which is scene one, but when we switch to Cam Link, we're gonna need to go ahead and add it. So, to add it, all we have to do is click Add, and we're gonna go to Audio Input Capture. Now, for this, I'm gonna recreate what I had set up earlier. So it's gonna go back to Rode NT1, and we can call this XLR. You just need to name it after whatever mic you're using. I am, of course, using the Rode NT1 as seen here. So why don't we go ahead and hit OK. Then it's gonna need to find it. Now, it's gonna default to whatever your default audio device is. So for me, this is the Line MGX-U, which is the name of the system I'm using to record audio. So I'm gonna hit OK. Now that is what is actually set up. And as you can see here, we have our audio being recorded to OBS, but we still have no image. If we go back to scene one, as you can see here in scene one, we are at the webcam, but we wanna use the Cam Link 4K. So what we're gonna need to do is we are going to need to add a brand new video source, a video capture device. So why don't we go ahead here, and we're gonna name this after our camera. So Panasonic G7. So one thing you're gonna wanna do immediately is mute your Panasonic G7 input. Otherwise you'll get, as you'll hear here, double audio, and it does not sound really good. So as we click there, you'll hear that it goes back to just our default audio setup as we have here. And you really don't wanna have that double audio. It doesn't sound good. Now you may notice a slight delay, and if there is a slight delay within what I'm saying to what you see on screen, we will also be fixing that. So first off, I wanna make sure that we have it custom, and it's gonna be, as we set up earlier, in 4K, so we're gonna choose that option because we're gonna be scaling down 4K to 1080p. We're gonna make sure we match it. It's gonna be at 29.97 as we set up a little earlier. For video format, I keep this on any. For color space, I usually go for 709 or 601, but you can leave it at default. Of course, these are all within YUV color space. It's pretty simple to understand, but why don't we just leave it at default? Color range, I wanna make sure that we have the full spectrum of color that this camera can produce, so you may notice a slight change there. We're gonna leave this to auto detect, and down here you can see some options for our audio output mode, so you can capture audio from the Panasonic G7, but because we already set up an external audio source, I'm not gonna wanna go ahead and do that. Now that we have this, we're gonna hit okay, but as you notice, it's not filling the screen, so we're gonna right click on the screen, hit transform, and we're gonna go to fit to screen. And here we have it. Now you should be able to see my Logitech C920 within the frame, and that is completely fine, at least for this demonstration. And immediately you should notice a difference in sharpness and clarity between the two. Now one thing you may notice is the slight offset between what I'm saying and how it's coming out of my mouth. We're gonna head back to OBS, and I found this online and it works pretty well for me, and it should work for you, though you can always look up your specific devices. So if we go into advanced audio properties, I wanna create an offset between my Rode NT1 and my Panasonic G7. So what I found to work best is a 233 offset, and as you should notice now, it should be better sync. So if I snap in 3, 2, 1, you should have heard that in real time. And that's just a quick way to fix that. Now, I want to show you again that direct comparison between a webcam and the Cam Link, so let's go ahead and set that up. Now, the reason I had the scene earlier with the webcam was so I could do this. So we're going to click studio mode. We're going to click scene, and if I transition, what I'm going to do now is at the output here, you should just notice. Now, I'm just going to hold still, and all I'm going to do while I look at the webcam is give you a comparison now. The main thing I want you to focus on between the two is how much more clarity there is when we're using the Cam Link 4K. For this demonstration, I'm not using the natural profile which we set up. So you may notice a difference in the brightness and the color contrast between the C920 and the Cam Link 4K. But in a bit here, I'm gonna go ahead and do a little bit of audio mixing and some color correction, so you can see what this can look like if you're recording. But for a live stream setup, using that natural profile set within your camera really can make all the difference. Though since I was recording this for video, I figured this made a little more sense. So let me show you what this can look like with a little bit of color processing, as well as just a touch of audio fixing. And that's gonna be happening in 3, 2, 1. So here we are, we should hear a little bit of a difference, and you should see some more color to this image. Again, since I was recording this natively into OBS, for the purposes of this video, you should be able to see that big difference I was talking about. But that's really how easy it is to set this up for live streaming. Now, going back to OBS, the final thing you have to do is go within settings, go to stream, and wherever you want to stream to, be it YouTube, be it any of these amazing websites, you enter in your key here, and then you go ahead and get ready to stream. Now, this is not a full in-depth OBS tutorial. It is just a how to set this up within OBS Studio, which is the device of choice for myself, and it gives you a way to do it. Again, OBS Studio is free to download, so it's super simple and super easy to stream with the Elgato Cam Link 4K. That's really gonna be it for this video. Let me know, are you streaming with the Elgato Cam Link 4K, or are you using a Logitech C920? I'm curious, what are you using to stream with? I'm Andrew Can, and remember, if I can, you can too. If you'd like to see me maybe do an OBS tutorial, also let me know in those comments down below. Thank you all so much for watching.